What is up, guys? How's it going today? My name is Syratube, and today I'm going to be discussing how a grand exchange tax would affect the OSRS economy. Specifically, we'll be talking about the 1% tax that Jagex has recently mentioned and is considering adding into the game. Jagex claimed that this would actually be the single biggest gold sink in the entire game, and right now, we do actually need a pretty good gold sink for the economy. That being said, let's take a look at how actually adding a GE tax will affect item prices and the overall economy in-game. The first thing that I'd like to discuss about the addition of the GE tax is the potential for scamming. If a 1% GE tax is applied every time you buy and sell an item on the Grand Exchange, players will be discouraged to actually use the Grand Exchange and will be more likely to trade with other players to avoid losing money. This is already happening in like a scam kind of sense, even though players can buy these items off of the Grand Exchange for pretty much the most accurate price available. Adding a tax would actually discourage players, like I said, from using the GE, and more players will focus on peer-to-peer trading to kind of avoid this 1% tax. It doesn't seem that significant right now, but if you're trading a large quantity of items, that 1% tax is really going to eat into you over time. So this is kind of opening a window for scammers if they do add this tax, and because there will actually be a reason to trade with other players in-game, as opposed to just splitting maybe a boss drop with someone and just using the Grand Exchange otherwise for actual item trading. Enough of this scamming talk though, let's talk about the actual market effects that this tax will have. If a GE tax is added into the game, the first thing we're going to see is a decline in GE trading. Less people, even if it is like a relatively small amount, will stop trading as frequently using the Grand Exchange. And this is going to happen because the tax will deter people from constantly buying and selling items on the Grand Exchange, as they will be losing money every time that they do so. It might not seem like a lot with only a 1% tax on most items, or actually I think every single item they said will have a 1% tax. It doesn't seem like a lot, but if you're trading a high quantity of items, or you're trading an item that costs a lot of money, that 1% tax is really going to eat into you. Think about players who maybe buy a certain PVM weapon or PVM armor just to go bossing for a little bit and then they sell it back afterwards. Well, first of all, you're paying a 1% tax twice, so you're going to pay 2% for an item that you're going to buy and sell later. And besides that, the item could decrease in price, so you're already going to be losing money in that sense. With less trades going on, item margins will increase due to items being traded less frequently, so this will be actually beneficial for people like me who like to flip and buy and sell items. And while this is the case, items will also decrease in stability, and items will be more likely to fluctuate in price. So nothing is going to be as safe as it is right now in the current state of the game where trading is free. So we're going to see bigger price fluctuations and more frequent price fluctuations, even if it is only very, very slight. This won't really affect the most traded items in the game, such as like sharks, blood runes, and silver scales, and other high quantity items as much as it will affect certain armors and weapons, specifically high-end PVM armor and weapons like the Twisted Bow, Scythe of Vitur. Those are things that are going to fluctuate a lot more because of this. The GE tax is really going to have an effect on flippers, as they'll have to find margins which will cover this 1% tax. The calculations for flipping will actually be a little more difficult because of this 1% tax, and flippers will have to eat a 1% tax every time they want to do an in-game margin check. So that will actually make programs such as GE Tracker and Platinum Tokens more effective. That being said, the tax will increase margins slightly on every item in the game because they're not being traded as much, as I mentioned before. So margins will offset from their current state to kind of reflect this tax. Personally, I do not like the idea of the GE tax, although it doesn't really affect flippers too much besides having a more costly margin check. There are plenty of other ways for Jagex to implement gold sinks in the game, which I've kind of touched on in my other videos on my channel. A GE tax overall discourages players from using the Grand Exchange, and I think it actually deters players from actually playing the game, and I really don't think this is a solution to the underlying problem within the game and its need for an actual very effective gold sink. Don't get me wrong, this would be a very effective gold sink if it was added. I just don't think the negatives really outweigh the positive of having one really good gold sink when there actually is other solutions to this problem. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments about this GE tax, if you think it would be an adequate gold sink for Jagex to implement into the game, and if you think it is the right idea. If you are interested in learning how to flip in old school RuneScape, feel free to join my Discord. There's a link in the description below. It's specifically built to teach old and new players how to flip in RuneScape and make a ton of bank from it. I've gotten a ton of good feedback about people who enjoy it in the Discord and have learned to become way better flippers because of it. So if you guys are interested in that, definitely join that. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you all next time.